Hello, welcome back to another CommandBlock minigame video. Yeah, it's been a while actually, so I figured we needed another one. Actually, this is part of the reason it's been a while. This minigame took a long time to make. So this minigame, basically how it works, is in your inventory, or in front of you, sometimes it flashes in front of you, sometimes it appears in your inventory, you'll have some sort of wool, and it'll be across your inventory like that. And so when you get the wool, you'll have to run to the, like, the thing, the whatever this is, yeah, tile, you have to run to the tile, and then everything else is... everything else goes away, and you're left standing, or if you don't make it in time, then you fall. So then the next one appears, and it's completely random. There's no pattern. There's no pattern that you can use to figure it out. You can't memorize it, because it's different every single time. It can do the same thing twice in a row, or never at all during the match. And there's 17 rounds, and during each round, it increases in speed, so you have to get there faster, basically. So I'm going to show you how I built it, and so this is part of the secret. So here is what I use. This glowstone is just so you can't see all of that. And then over here, what I'm doing is I'm cloning from where I'm standing all the way to the other corner whenever it's red. So it'll clone that here, so everything else will disappear except for the red. And if it's purple, it'll clone the purple down there. And it will include the air blocks, so even the air blocks will be placed here. So, now this is why it took a long time to make. Yeah, this is quite a contraption, I would say. So let's get into what you need to type before. Color dummy. Actually, I don't even think I use this one. I might have, we'll see. And then add CT dummy color timer. And then add this is dummy brought to you by the builder, you don't need that. But color player dummy. So the color player objective is just what we're using in this mini game to track if you're in the game. So then alright, so let's get into how this works. This is how it's supposed to be set up when the match isn't running. Everything should be like this, and this redstone wire should be here, and nothing in this area, and this should be here. So what happens is, this is just a set block command that sets a redstone block right there. So the redstone block then powers this. So it powers this system, and so this will remain powered. This, it'll go up to here. This piston will retract and pull this redstone block over this command block. So then this one will be constantly activated. And the reason it's constantly activated is because of this fill clock. So I have a fill clock, and it's exactly the same as we had before, except this one has zero replace stone, and the other one below it has zero replace redstone block. So basically that means it will, if it detects stone, it will turn it into a redstone block. And if it detects a redstone block, it'll turn it into stone. So it'll just continuously complete the cycle. But if there's no block, say it's just like that, then it doesn't really care about that block. It doesn't affect it. So that allows me to just place and break these, and it will just shut off, but if it's placed, it will continuously run. So here I am affecting all entities who are named slow and are within 30 blocks. I'm giving them slowness. So then I'm giving, let's see. Then I'm setting the block. If this, there's a villager. So there's a villager right in here. Hey, how's it going? Alright, so there's a villager right in there. And if he has a CT score of 1 or less, 1 or less, and he's within 5 blocks, which that one is, and if that's true, then it will set the block 5 blocks below him, it'll set a redstone block. So, this block. So, if he has a CT score on 1 or less, then it will set this block. So that's just what happens. So he is the timer. This is how I'm timing the entire system. So he is in charge of the timing. So then over here, let's see. This one, execute at random entity. At random entity, whose type equals pig and whose name is slow, it will set block below them, 3 blocks below them, it'll set a redstone wire. So that is why I had the other command block over here that's constantly adding a slowness effect. So in here, let's see, we have a bunch of pigs named slow. They're in each one of these things. So when this round gets triggered, a random one of these at random, a random pig, will set a redstone wire. And it'll set it below them. So it'll set it on one of these wool blocks. And each one of these wool blocks represents the round. So this is the red, blue, so that decides which tile they have to run to, basically. So it randomly sets it there, and since there's a redstone block here, it's activated, and it will activate the command block. So let's say the yellow one is activated. So it will clear the player's inventory. So if they had wool in their inventory from before, it'll clear it. Then this will give them wool 4. So that's the yellow wool. And these are all the same along here. Let's see. All the same all the way across there. So that just fills up the entire inventory with yellow wool. And then over here. So, wait, I'm going to get to that a little bit later. Okay, so then over here. So this triggers one of these lines of command blocks. Then what it does is it sets the villager to a CT score of 90. So this command block will no longer constantly this one will no longer constantly place the redstone block here. So that one will, this will no longer be constantly placed, and since that is no longer constantly placed, we have this thing. This is built to destroy what it does, basically. So first of all, I'm going to show you what this redstone block does. So it fills an area with redstone wire. And this fills the same area with air. So I'm going to grab both of these command blocks. And I'm just going to place them down. And let's place them down. And this is what happens. Okay, great example. There we go. So that's what happens. It sets redstone wire all along here. And so when it sets redstone wire all along there. And this one sets the score over here, so this won't be activated yet. So let me get rid of this. Is this one? Oh well. I'll delete that later. So this command block is constantly placing that, but when this block triggers that, it will stop constantly placing it. And then this one will set block air where that one is. So it will set an air block. So if this is not constantly being placed, it'll be set air, and this will be deactivated. And this will activate this, which will set air all along here. So that will just reset the system. And this one will just kill all items. So it's kind of annoying. When you break the redstone wire, it creates like a bunch of items. So I just have them die. And that's just how I do it. Just a clear lag kind of a thing. So then when this is powered, and then where's the command block that I'm looking for? It's the one over here. So this one will constantly remove one from the CT score of the villager. So this will be counting down one per tick. So every tick it'll be going down, so really fast. And this redstone block will be constantly activating it, since this piston will be retracted. So this doesn't work if the game is off like this. So it will only work if the game is on. And how you turn it on, just press that button. So it's constantly counting down. This pushes it up to 90, and then it's still counting down. So when it counts down back to zero, this will activate again. And this will be placed. So that basically means after 90 ticks, which is specified here, this will be placed. And it will have a little bit of a delay. Then it will fill an area with redstone wire. So it will fill on top of these iron blocks will be redstone wire. So whichever one is powered, it'll continue to go down, and then it will hit this command block after 90 ticks and those repeaters. So then this will clone the area. So this one was purple. So it'll clone the purple section down there, and everything else will disappear. So then it'll wait a few counts, because you want it to disappear and then have to stand there for like a few seconds or something like that. So then it clears the player's inventory. It clones the top one back down, so it resets it basically, and then it fills this area with air, so it resets that. It sets air back here, so whichever one is activated, it'll set air back here, so all the wool blocks will be cleared. Then the last one will fill an area with redstone wire. So the area being filled is these sandstone blocks. So when this is done disappearing the rest of the area and then resetting it, this will fill that area with air. It'll fill this area with air. It will set air all the way over there. And then this one will set a redstone wire here so that this one can now be activated. So now this one will continue the entire cycle again. So that's how I switch from rounds. And every time it goes a little bit less. So it's 88 ticks, then 86 ticks, then 84, and all the way down till you get to here, which has only 15 ticks to get to your destination. So that's really not that long. But I made it quite short because it actually takes the computer, depending on how fast your computer is, it will take a while to clone the area. So I added a little bit less delay, so it will account for that delay. So then, eventually this will do the same thing when it gets to the last round. It will place a redstone wire here, and then it will activate this. So it will set air. So it will set air over here. Then it will also place down this redstone wire again, and it will then set air here, since this one will have a wire. Then when it's done doing that, I have this thing which will teleport all players who have a color player score, and then it will then reset their color player score. So it'll just teleport them out of the game and then reset them. So then I added these two blocks are the death mechanics. And so this one it resets the player's score of color player. So if they fall, you want it to be reset so it doesn't still think they're in the game. So what this does to do that is it takes a coordinate, an X and a Y, or X and a Z coordinate, it's like in the middle of the area, then 100 blocks below it, and within a radius of 100, it will get anyone within that area. So basically, if I fall too far down, since 100 blocks is pretty far, bigger than the entire arena, they will fall and then they will be teleported. And then this second one over here, it teleports them, but this one it's 10 blocks below that. So they fall after they get to zero. When they get to Y equals zero, then they will be reset. And then when they get to Y equals negative 10, then they will be teleported. And because they're accelerating and they're in adventure mode, I teleported them here, where they will fall into water and they won't take fall damage. Otherwise, they'd just fall and immediately die. And this is also the same location they're teleported at the end of the match. So that is all. Simple, huh? So, yeah, this is why it took me a while. This and some other projects. There's one over there that I've been waiting to show off. But I'm going to do that in a shorter video. This one's too long for that. So, I think now it's time to play the game. I'm going to be right back while I destroy these redstone wires. Alright, redstone wires are destroyed, and now it is time to play. So, I just added this, so if the game is going on, you can run over this pressure plate, and this one only, and you'll get a color player score. So then, when the round goes, you'll see the wool in your inventory, then you can run along here, and then you can go to that wool block. So you can actually play the game, even if you weren't there from the start. Or if you die and you want to come back, you can always do that. So this one puts me in adventure mode. This one clears my inventory. This one gives me a color player score, and this one teleports me. So If you run along those, you won't really notice. This one sets the block over there. I saw wool, or yellow wool, so it will be placed over there, and now it will disappear. Boom. So there's a little bit of a delay. You saw it being placed, and then there's a little bit of a delay until this was eliminated, and that's just because of lag, and it can't do that. So I am going to play a full game. Sometimes it just flashes in your inventory, like that time. I hope it's purple. Yeah, it is purple. So other times you actually get it in your inventory and it doesn't go away. Oh, one problem that I didn't fix yet. I just realized the problem. I am taking hunger. So I have hunger bars going down. So eventually I'll run out of hunger, but that's not really a problem. I can just add one command block and just give all players saturation. So that's an easy fix. I'll add that before I make the download for this map. And the download will be in the description. So, yeah. This is a pretty good game. It took me a while. This is why it took me a while. This game. It's a lot of command blocks. I counted, it's like over 300. So. Oh, wrong one. Ah. Boom. I almost went on the wrong one. Almost died. Or did I? Yeah, I'm right. Okay, let's do this. Okay, I'm going to give myself saturation the next time I run to the block. Oh, slash effect the builder 2300/100. And I think I'm going to do this. No, it's the other one. Yeah. Blue. Okay, blue wool. I believe it is blue. I hope it is blue. Otherwise, I'm dead. Yeah, it was blue. See that skill? I just know it. And the hardest part was getting it to switch between systems, because it has to time, and it has to decide which one, and it has to do all of them in the right order, and it has to do it randomly, and it's like, yeah, it took a while to figure it out, but I was able to. Originally, I had silverfish inside those areas instead of pigs. But they kept despawning, even though they were named, which isn't supposed to happen. But it did, so I changed it to pigs. So pigs work. Yeah, pigs are awesome. So, yeah. That's why I did it. And then, yeah. So this is the fourth minigame? Yeah, fourth minigame. Fourth minigame I have created. I believe it was pink. Not for sure. Well, if it wasn't pink, then it's a good example of falling. Yeah, this is a good example. So it just teleports me right down there. So that's how you make your own. I don't know that you would want to go through all the trouble of creating your own. If I were you, I'd just download this map. Although, if I was me, I would create it by myself. Like I did this time. So anyway, if you want to adjust the times, you can just change this, change that number on all of these command blocks, and then you can make it shorter or longer. I would make it shorter. Yeah. But if you have a faster computer, then it should, if you have a faster computer than mine, it should make it so that it's a less delay, because it'll disappear more quickly. When it activates that command block, it kind of waits. So if you have a fast computer, it won't wait. And speaking of a faster computer, I should be getting one. So when I get one, which will be probably next 2 or 3 videos, considering I'm going to be doing a lot more videos, then I can restart my modded survival series. But I don't want to continue that one until I have a fast computer, because I have some plans, and they're going to require one. So, yeah, that's just my plans, or me talking about my plans. I haven't told you what they are yet. You have to wait to find out. Yes. So, until next time, builders, I am the builder. Farewell.